Leadership plays a key role in the success of any business, but leaders in any organization do not work in isolation. They work through their teams. Organizations are not built merely by strategy, but by teams that execute these strategies. In light of this, we are celebrating the golden teams behind the success of notable organizations in Africa, among them Kenya Women Microfinance Bank.
This organization was started way back more than 30 years ago. And the women who had started it, their intention and what they wanted to achieve is to have a women bank. And the reason why they thought they wanted a women's bank is because women were being discriminated within the banking sector. They could not get loans, they could not even get credit cards. Women had reached a point where even a woman to open a savings account, they had to be introduced by their husbands or their fathers.
Kenya Women Microfinance Bank was created to provide access to financial services to women to enable them improve their economic status and livelihoods.
It was that time headed by Mrs. Mary Okero. She was a banker and she was the first woman banker in Kenya.
Kenya Women Microfinance Bank enjoys a unique status in financial services as the only financial institution to focus solely on women clients.
Our target market primarily is women. But you see, the good thing with women, if you look at a woman at the household level, then you'll see she works for the family. When this organization was formed, we felt that the best way to enter the family and the most economical way, and this is known, we talk about if you want to educate a country, educate a woman. So if you want to economically empower a family, you've got to go through the route of women. Women are much better in managing resources. In fact, we don't discriminate men. What we do is we say we enter the family but use the woman as the entry point.
Since its inception over 32 years ago, KWFT has risen to be one of the most successful microfinance institutions in the country, with the largest network of any microfinance institution providing deep penetration into rural and urban areas of Kenya. Its clientele base has grown to over 800,000 clients.
We are in 45 of the 47 counties of this country. In fact, might it not be for insecurity, we would be in all the counties of this country. We are a rural financial institution. 80% of our activities are out there in the villages because development is very key for us. We have a very strong workforce. In fact, out of the regulated 9 microfinance banks, another 3, other than this one, are managed by our former employees. We use the Japanese approach of management that we teach our employees that the company belongs to them. They will work and retire here. We have schemes that are able to address their needs. If you come to things like our medical scheme, we are talking about a scheme that is uniform across board. In fact, the difference between my position and the position of the person who opened the gate for you is just responsibility. For 3 years, we have always been among the top 3 best company to work for. It's not because of the money we give them. It's not because of salaries. It's because of the environment that we have created within the company. It's a company that serves the people, but it's also managed by ourselves.
Staying true to their mission of bringing development to the rural woman, KWFT has created products that directly address the woman at the grassroots level.
We have products that we call Touching Life products. These are products that we put together to make sure, because they are not business products. But you see, if you look at the life cycle of a woman, she needs money, but she also needs a good life. She needs to reach a point where life is bearable. So one of the products that we came up with is water and sanitation. For water, it's a question of reducing the time women spend going to look for water from the rivers or from the dams. The other product that we came up with, and all these things came from women themselves, is they wanted something that can be able to address the cooking requirements. They want to be in a kitchen because they have not refused to be in the kitchens. They have no problem with it. But can the kitchen be bearable? Can we have a kitchen that is smoke-free? We felt that at that point we needed to come up with energy-saving jiko that can use less firewood, less smoke. So it saves the woman the time she spends looking for firewood. At the same time, it also helps the woman to avoid inhaling too much smoke at the household level. We also have solar, because you see, in the rural area, if you go to the rural area, you find most people use kerosene lamps. You keep inhaling smoke from it. So we came up with a solar solution that we can be able to harvest the sun and be able to light the household. Now we have moved to an even more interesting product. We are talking about home improvement, Nyumba Smart. We are looking at a situation where people who live in mud houses can be able to improve their homes to have to move towards brick houses. And those ones who are in brick houses can be able to put stone houses. We are talking about changing the way the rural economies are.
One of the clients to benefit from the Touching Lives products is Grace Kamene Mutua. Grace Kamene hails from Makutano Township, 25 kilometers from Matuu Town in Machakos County. Her life and that of her family has transformed significantly since she joined the bank in the year 2010.
Nikioa Grace, nilimwambia mimi niko na nyumba kubwa. Na mimi nilikuwa na hata kanyumba kale, nilikuwa nako ni kadogo. Kenya nilijenga nako na bado kazi ikakuwa nyingine tu, lakini sio nyumba ambaye mtu anaweza sema ako na nyumba.
After nikimaliza masomo ndio nilienda town, nikapatana na mzee. Maisha ya town ikanishinda, nikakuja huko nyumbani. Nilianza kabiashara na 20,000. Nikianza biashara, nikakaa, nikaona kuna mahali wa mama wanakimbia. Nikauliza achia lady, nikamwambia, nataka kujua mama huo wanafanya nini. Nikaingia Kenya Women, nikachukua loan ya 30,000. Mzee akaniongezea, nikaenda, nikanunua motorbike. Nikimaliza mwaka, nikachukua loan ya 50,000. Nikaongeza kwa biashara. Nikakaa, nikapatiwa tenda ya Father Makewa High School. Nikaanza kusupply mboga. Nikisupply mboga, nikaona niko na pesa nalipwa every month yenye inanilipia loan. Nikawa naweza lisha watoto. Naweza kifaidi maisha yangu. Pesa zenye nilikuwa nachukua za loan sasa zikaanza kujitoa, sasa nikapata za kusave, kukula. Nikaona hizi pesa ni nyingi, sasa nitafanya aje. Nikasikia kuna kitu inaitwa nyumba loan. Hapo ndio niliweza kuuliza mwalimu, na iko aje? Mwalimu akaniambia, utajengewa nyumba kubwa kutoka chini. Kamuuliza ni ukweli? Akaniambia ni ukweli. Nikapatiwa form, nikajaza loan, nikajenga nyumba.
You go to talk to those women, you discover that the fact that they have received these services from us and we understand them, we relate with them. When she is unwell, we go to see her. If the husband is not feeling well, we are available. If the child is not well, we are available. We go to the house. We go to their homes. We relate with them. We understand their needs. We partner at her level.
Ile kazi mnafanya, hiyo ni kazi ya maana. Sababu, kama tumeambiwa, mama akiamuka akatae kasi. Iyo siku, inchi yetu inaangamia. Pesa Kenya Women tuko nazo. Si munaona bank, mulikuwa munaenda Kitui, sio? Sasa bank imefika wapi?
Matuu,
si ndio? Miaka mingine mitatu ikifika, mimi nataka kukuta bank hapa Makutano.
Grace Kamene Mutua is just one among thousands of Kenyan women who have benefited immensely from the KWFT products.
Mama wa Kenya, watoke kwa analog, kuje dingi toka we si mama wa KWFT. Jua umeachwa. Juu hiyo bank inasaidia wa mama, wazee, si inaitwa KWFT jina, but inasaidia hata wanaume. So si wa mama pekee.
Ningehimiza wanaume wenzangu waambie waingie Kenya Women Finance Trust, sababu nikiwa Kenya Women Finance Trust nimepata solar yenye inawaka kwa hii nyumba yangu, nimepata jiko ile ya kupika. Kama sio Kenya Women Finance Trust, hatungeweza pata hiyo nyumba.
By the way, mimi niko na matarajio nyingi kupitia KWFT. Naona mambo yangu itakuwa mzuri. Mtoto wangu ako bado class 5 ananiambia nataka kuwa doctor. Sasa nikiingia Kenya Women naona nitapatiwa school fees, mtoto nitafunza, nitanunua matank, nitanunua gari, nataka ball. Nitachukua pesa Kenya Women nichimbiwe through KWFT. Ni nini itanishinda?
I felt extremely good when I saw where they came from in terms of their house, the steps they have taken, the faith they have in their business, and the fact that they know that when they work hard and they do savings and they work with KWFT, we are able to change their lives and the lives of their neighborhood.
The Golden Team at Kenya Women Microfinance Bank continues to look for ways to alleviate poverty and bring social economic development in Kenya through its products and services.
We are opening more branches, of course, across the country because there are areas that we need to reach out there. We are also introducing agency banking because we believe that we should take banking down to the villages. And on top of that, we make sure that the women who we work with, who are our members and our clients, are the ones who run agency banking. So women move from where women feared going to the banking hall to a situation where women themselves are banking each other. I would like to challenge the women of this country. I'm a man. I've committed myself to empowerment of women. What I would ask is that all the women who have resources, please bring the resources to us. And if we do that, then women can empower themselves.